Joining me is author Lisa Genova, author of Still Alice, which became an equally successful movie. She has written since then three books which continue to inspire. Lisa, thank you so much for coming to Madison and thank you for sitting down with us.
Oh, you bet. Thank you for having me.
So, you have a PhD in neuroscience at Harvard. You were a strategist for healthcare industry. What made you decide to change and become an author?
Yeah, isn't that what every neuroscientist becomes, a novelist? Yeah, it wasn't a planned, like, conscious ambition. My grandmother had Alzheimer's, mm-hmm. and I could understand her disease as a neuroscientist, and I could read everything about it and learn about how to be a caregiver. Mm-hmm. But everything was written from the point of view of a scientist, a clinician, a caregiver, a social worker. And what was missing was an understanding of what it felt like from her perspective.
You do take an inside-out approach with several of your novels. Why is that?
Yeah, I didn't set out to become a novelist, but what happened with Still Alice was I recognized that this was an incredible opportunity to educate the general public about people living with neurological diseases and disorders who tend to be ignored, feared, or misunderstood. So most people aren't going to go pick up the Journal of Neuroscience this month and learn about Alzheimer's or Huntington's or autism or brain injury, but they might read a novel.
And it was interesting that your character, Alice, you chose a younger woman, where most people, as you said, think of Alzheimer's at the end of life, that end stage.
Yeah.
Why a younger character with early onset?
Right, and so my grandmother was in her 80s, and I originally didn't set out with an age in mind. It happened for a few reasons. The people that I came to know when I was doing the research for this book, I came to know 27 people living with Alzheimer's who shared with me every day for the year and a half that I was writing this book what it feels like to have it. Amazing, generous people. And they were in their 40s, 50s, and 60s. These are people who are still in the early stages who can still communicate what it feels like to have this.
I just remember so many scenes of the book where she was running and she got lost, or she was sitting in a lecture waiting for the person to speak, and you as the reader knew that she was the one who was supposed to give the lecture. You just made it so real for all of us.
Thank you.
Of the books you have written since Still Alice, is there one that you would like to be seen turn into a movie again?
Yeah, this is like asking me to pick my favorite kid, which on any given day I do have a favorite.
You have three children,
by
the way.
Mm-hmm. So the other books are Left Neglected, about a woman with a traumatic brain injury. Love, Anthony is about a boy with nonverbal autism, mm-hmm. so giving a voice to that voiceless boy. And the most recent one is Inside the O'Briens, about a family with Huntington's. I think I get a little better with each book. I mean, I love them all.
Sure.
This most recent one is the one I'd like to see next.
Final question. Has all of this success with Still Alice and Left Neglected and Love, Anthony, and then Inside the O'Briens, has this surprised you?
Yeah.
Do you ever just step back and say, this is my life?
Of course.
Wow.
Yeah. And well, Still Alice, I couldn't get that published. No one wanted it because it's about Alzheimer's, and who's going to want to read that? So I self-published it and sold it out of the trunk of my car for a year.
That is amazing.
So, you know, this time last year, I was packing a dress to go to the Oscars. I just recently was in Los Angeles to talk about Alzheimer's. Again, one of the things mm-hmm. I'm lucky enough to get to do is to advocate for people living with this disease and to educate and to speak about this and to help raise awareness and funds for research. And so I'm out there and I got to have lunch with one of the producers and the director from the film, and we're all like, we cried during lunch because it's like, we can't believe that this all actually really happened. Mm-hmm. It really happened.
Well, yeah. We are so thankful for the work that you're doing, not
you.
Only for the families, but also for the people that are going through all of this. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Lisa Genova.